Hey guys, so today is Wednesday, the 20th of February. It's very rainy outside. I can let you see that here in my neck of the woods. Lots of like flood advisories and things of that nature going on. Do you need to go back out? You go back out? Okay. I'll let the baby out. So here I'll let you see what I wear. Wore to work on this rainy day. Got on my hunter rain boots. Jeans are American Eagle. This cami, I want to say, was Walmart. I'm not for sure. Got a Kentucky Derby lanyard. My Kentucky Derby pin. Red earrings. And we're done. I actually didn't feel good this morning. I felt like I was getting a cold. So I doubled up on my vitamin C. And honey, feeling like rock star status again. I mean, not really, but I speak positivity on it. I read one time somewhere that if you like feel sick, instead of saying like, I'm coming down with a cold, you're supposed to say, I'm fighting a cold. Speaking like positivity, like I'm fighting a cold or I'm overcoming a cold. That would be a good way to say it. She's so happy to be in her yard. Had to have a new heating and cooling unit this week. That was a bloody fortune. What else? Oh, guys, this week we went and seen Southern Mama again. Do y'all remember when I went and seen him before? That's Darren Knight. He's a comedian. And he talks in the style of a Southern mom. He truly does. It was so funny. And here's another thing you might not know. I don't know that I've ever said it on a video. When I went and seen him before, I met him. Met all of the comedians that were there that night. He put out a video. Your girl is his thumbnail. Like, I'm Darren Knight's thumbnail in his video. So, like, if you go to all of his videos on YouTube, you'll see my shining face. So that was hilarious. I'm trying to think what else I've done this week that I needed to tell you about. Well, I mean, that was actually last week, so whatever. Let me tell you what we're doing today. We're going to be crafty and we're going to make a wreath. Yes. So I went to Hobby Lobby. Do you all know about tobacco baskets? Well, in case you didn't, you need to because they're fabulous. They have them on sale right now. For 50% off. So the basket itself was $25. This particular wreath that I got to hang in the middle of mine, well, you're so loud, was originally $25. It's on sale for $12. I mean, this is like really big. This is the large one. They come in three different sizes. This is the biggest one because things tend to look really small on my walls. So loving that. That was a total steal, if you ask me. So, loving the tobacco basket. As far as the wreath that I want to make, I actually found a tutorial on YouTube where a girl, like, she bought her ribbon. I think she said, like, at the Dollar Tree or something like that. I actually ordered mine on Amazon because, hello, I'm Erica, and I'm an Amazonaholic. And it's just so quick and easy, right? So, my aunt bought me, y'all know I love campers. So many of you have sent me campers in the mail. She bought me this little like wooden door hanging. I want to say she got this at Everything's a Dollar or Dollar Tree or Dollar, I don't know, Big Lots maybe. But I think it's just so cute. There we go. So you see how it is like yellow, black, and white. This is actually, it was more of like a lime green. And I dry brushed it a few minutes ago and made it more yellow because the ribbon that I ordered is more true yellow and it didn't match. So that has been dry brushed within the last 5 or 10 minutes. Then for my ribbon, so that girl on that video, I'm just going to follow her video. I'll link hers down below because she was the genius that did this. She used a wire wreath frame. I got 30 inches. Like, this is really big because the front door to my house is so big. Like, an 18 inch, sorry, wreath is not even going to show up. Like, it would look crazy on my door. So you use that. You connect all your ribbon with chenille stems, or if
you're from southeastern Kentucky, honey, pipe cleaners, whatever. I asked a girl at Hobby Lobby, I was like, where are your pipe cleaners? She was like, pipe cleaner? It was hilarious. I said, chenille stems, baby, chenille stems. So, I got a tickle in my throat. The first thing you do is you attach all your chenille stems. I'll show you that. And then she wrapped some mesh. Like, she did two different colors around just to kind of fill in, I think, in fluff. So, I got this kind of, like, gold, pale gold with shiny gold in it. And just a black mesh, okay? So, I'll do a row of each one of those. And then you use four colors of ribbon. I have two of each simply because my wreath frame is so large. I don't know how much I'm going to have to use. So, all of my ribbon is 2.5 inches wide. And these are 10 yards. So, I got two. So, I have 20 yards of yellow, 20 yards of sunflower, 20 yards of black glitter, and 50 yards of black and white check. So, I think those will all go really well with this yellow, black, and white little wreath. Whereas, you know, also from southeastern Kentucky, wreath, okay? Wreath hanger is. All right, so what I'm going to do is change my clothes, put on stretchy pants and a t-shirt, get my little doggy set up here with me because she gets anxious if I leave her in the floor. Yes, you got to help. She's a worker. Yes. And make a cup of coffee, and then I will come back, and we will start cutting ribbon, putting on our chenille stems, and making a wreath. See you on a bit. Here, okay, we gotta get in Piper's bed, okay? Mommy, you gotta get in your bed. Mommy's baby will fall. Here, there you go. The camera scared her. Okay, here. See, I got her some bones, and that way, Piper has to be with you while you work. She's a working baby. Okay. Come here. Yes.
You're so sweet.
Mm.
You're such a good baby.
I'm going to take a chenille stem, and you want to go, see how there's a section, section, section? In each section, put it on there, and you twist it twice, okay? So you're going to have a chenille stem there. Let me make sure you can see this good, especially since I have a helper. Okay, come here, baby. Okay, yes. Okay, put you back in the bed. Okay. Now, so in that section, see how I'm on this outside one here? I'm going to take it on the inside on the next one. And we're just going to twist them a couple times. Okay? So, you can see there's one in the top, one in the bottom. One in the top, one in the bottom. One in the top, one in the bottom. Top, bottom, top, bottom. Okay? I'm going to do that the whole way around. Alright guys, so I have put all of my chenille stems on my wreath frame, and as you can see, one in the top, one on the next row down, on the top one, on the next one down. Okay, so there's 15 sections on my particular wreath frame. You're just going to need to count that, okay? In each section, and keep in mind there's 15, I have two chenille stems. There's going to be a bow layered with all four of our ribbon on each stem. So I need two of each pattern for each section. So that's 30, okay? You need at least 30 strips of ribbon. And the video that I watched, she did it in 8-inch sections. Like her ribbon, she cut it in 8 inches. So I just like cut one, I measured it and cut it, and then I just use it as a guide. And these don't have to be exact, guys. I mean,
And basically, what I have found is if you get 10 yards of ribbon, if you have a big, huge wreath like mine, you're going to have more than enough. So, I bought double what I needed, but, you know, I had never done this before, and I didn't know with my wreath frame how much ribbon I would need. So, better too much than not enough. You know, I could always just get me another frame and make one for a friend. You know, make one for my mom. Each individual ribbon, you know, you want to cut it like a ribbon. So all you have to do that, just take your ribbon and fold it in half. And then cut it up at an angle from the end. Just like that. And you're going to have a ribbon cut. Okay, guys. So I have my, let me get you to turn around here. My ribbons all cut. I have 30 of each print. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is put a couple rows of my mesh just to fill it up because I want a really full wreath. But then all you do, according to her video, honey, you take one of each ribbon and she just kind of stacked them like that. Okay, and then she just squished it. And then she put them down in the center of each one of those little chenille ties and you just twist it twice, okay? You do that the whole way around. But see how this one has got, like I did this, then this, then this, then this, and the sunflowers on top? The next time, put, say, the black one on top. Then the next time, put the yellow one on top. Then the next time, put this one on top. And she said you just rotate out your patterns. Does that make sense? So, that's how we'll do that. But first, I'm going to wrap my chenille stem twice. Well, maybe two or three times. I want it to be good and tight. And then you just loop it, put like a loop. And then go to the next top one. Alright, so I have my gold kind of mesh the whole way around. And again, that's on that upper ring. On the lower ring, I'm going to do this black. And forget about that. I actually ended up taking the black out because it made it look a little bit too dark and Halloweenish. So I'm just going to skip this part. So in each little section, we have a top and a bottom, right? So I'm going to go to the top. Put it down. And make sure you get your chenille stem on there tight. Okay? And then, I think it's best to separate your bow out. Hey guys, so flash forward a couple of days. This is what we're looking at. I've been just working on this like in the evening time as I get home from work. Something you'll notice, I took off the black netting around the outside edge because it made it look kind of Halloweenish, you know, and I want this to be pretty and bright, a lot of yellow and red, and that I have enough of that black ribbon, that glitter ribbon. And, of course, black and white check. So I took that out, and, yeah, this is what we're looking at. I think I like it. You know, you tend to be critical of your own work, you know, but I think it's really pretty. We're going to try it. I don't know. I don't know if I love it, but we'll see. And then I have just some more ribbon cut up. You know, you can see, like, there's some areas that you could possibly add some more ribbon. This is yours. Fill it up. Do it how you want. There's a chance I'll hang it up and then keep adding stuff to it. I don't even know. But that's what it looks like. And I will show you the finished product.